When a passerby found this pack abandoned in a parking lot, they made a horrific discovery. Nowadays, finding an abandoned backpack is usually worth a call to the police. But when one passerby came across an unattended bag in a parking lot, he chose to take a peek inside instead. And nothing could have prepared him for what he found in there. Until very recently, Tempe, Arizona was arguably only famous for being home to NFL team, the Arizona Cardinals. But in light of one passerby's recent discovery, the city may become known for something else. It's unlikely to boost tourism in the area, though. On one June evening in 2017, a pedestrian happened to be passing by the Food City grocery store in Tempe. It's important to remember, though, that this is Arizona, and so, even though the sun was setting, the temperature was still over 100 degrees Fahrenheit at the time. The passerby, who has not been identified, has claimed that he approached a grocery cart and found a Jonas Brothers backpack inside. Instead of calling the police, however, he chose to open it up and take a look inside. And when he did, he must have suffered a huge shock. Specifically, the passerby had found a newborn baby girl swathed in a blanket. As a result, he immediately alerted the manager of the Food City store. The manager then dialed 911 for the fire department, telling the operator that the baby had likely been born very recently. Indeed, there was significant evidence that the baby had only been born hours before being discovered. For instance, the food store manager noted that the partly cut umbilical cord was still attached to the tiny girl. And the child couldn't have been in the backpack for that long, as it would have struggled to have survived in the heat. In light of this information, finding the baby's parents was the authorities' number one priority. Consequently, local police have begun an investigation to try and track them down. At the present time, however, their identities remain unknown. As a result, the police have decided to explore all avenues. Local news stations, for instance, have showcased officers even dusting nearby payphones for prints. But although the hope is that any fingerprints found will be on file, the truth is that even using this method could take weeks to yield results. At the time, meanwhile, the baby was taken to hospital in an ambulance for a checkup. Subsequently, it was declared that the child was in good health. However, given that the mother had just given birth, she was publicly urged to also get herself checked out by a doctor. And, perhaps most strangely, the baby was actually abandoned within sight of a fire station. This is important, since in Arizona, all hospitals and fire departments are stated to be safe havens. This label means that babies can be surrendered there with no penalty, so long as the baby is not more than 72 hours old. Another key point is the existence of the Aid to Women's Center, located close to where the baby was dropped. It's also designated as a safe haven, offering medical and mental care to women in need. Surprisingly, the mother also chose not to leave her child there. However, while speaking to ABC 15 Arizona in June 2017, Katrina Wynn from the Aid to Women's Center suggested that it might have been shame that kept the mother from choosing a safe haven. Talking about mothers that abandon their babies, Wynn said, "They're thinking anyone's better than them, anyone's more capable than them. They'll leave it for someone more capable and with hope to find." After all, abandoning a baby is surely no parent's first choice. Whoever left that newborn girl in a parking lot would probably have done so because they felt they really had no other option. Indeed, they likely believed that the child was better off in the hands of another. What's more, this incident is far from the first of its kind. In fact, there are numerous incredible stories that show that the safe haven laws have been a welcome invention. In particular, a woman in California recently spoke of having abandoned not one, but three children in the 60s and 70s. Sadly, though, countless babies are abandoned in the US every year. In 2017, for instance, a crying newborn was discovered in a truck bed in Florida. The newborn was raced to hospital, where 46-year-old respiratory specialist Lorraine Nichols was among those waiting to treat him. And there and then, she resolved that she would do whatever she could to ensure that the infant need not feel cold or alone ever again. Meanwhile, at the hospital, doctors estimated that the unfortunate baby was less than 1 week old, and he was in quite a sorry state. Despite Suarez's special heated mattress, the newborn was suffering from hypothermia due to the cold. In addition, the baby was extremely hungry. What's more, the fact that his soft skin was peeling away suggested that he was severely dehydrated. "My heart just went out to him," Nichols later admitted. However, despite everything that the baby had been through in his short life already, his future looked promising. "I assessed his breathing, his, you know, oxygen," Nichols told TV news show USA Today's online Humankind platform in February 2018. "For the most part, he was fine. Cold, hungry, wet, but he was fine." While Nichols had no doubt treated countless patients over the course of her 18-year career, there was something immediately different here. She had instantly fallen head over heels in love with the abandoned baby. And straight away, the medic knew that this was her chance to become a mom. But, like the forsaken infant, Nichols had faced hardships in her life too, including overcoming breast cancer not once, but twice. What's more, the medical specialist had been desperate to become a mother. Her retired military man husband, 66-year-old Charles, had come with 3 children of his own, but they had been practically fully grown. So the couple had spent thousands of dollars on IVF treatments in an attempt to become pregnant. But eventually, doctors warned against it, as apparently the hormones involved in the process could have caused Nichols's cancer to return. As a result, the couple had decided to go down the adoption route. But after completing the arduous vetting process, the Nichols were disappointed to discover that it could be a few years before a suitable child came their way. The respiratory specialist had previously turned to God for a resolution, and it seemed those prayers had been answered. Nichols now held her dream baby in her arms. Indeed, as soon as she clapped eyes on the abandoned mite, the overwhelmed woman was already experiencing the bond of motherhood. Feeling there was no time to lose then, Nichols called her husband and told him that she wanted to adopt the newborn. Charles readily agreed to her wishes, as he later told the Tallahassee Democrat. "I just wanted to support my wife," he said. "Whatever she wants, whatever makes her happy, makes me happy." And it was a seemingly elated and hopeful Nichols who called the Florida Department of Children and Families and her case manager at the local Children's Home Society regarding a possible adoption. Things from there moved fast. While the baby was kept in hospital for observation, the Children's Department empowered Nichols to make decisions on his behalf, since the infant had no one. 4 days later, then, the newborn, whom the medic had decided to call Charlie, came home with her. While Nichols had helped to raise her stepchildren, her first week as the mom of a newborn appeared to be a steep learning curve. "Some women have 9 months to prepare for that. I had 1 week," she told Humankind. "I was just scared I was gonna break him." However, despite the challenges instant motherhood posed, Nichols was just grateful for the opportunity of being a parent. "It's just been amazing," she told the cameras in the film news report, which has since been uploaded to YouTube. "He's my miracle, my angel. He's all my prayers been answered. This is what I've been praying for years." And in September 2017, 4 months after Charlie's rescue, his adoption by the Nichols became official. So now, the family could finally start making big plans for their future together. These included preparations for the baby's first Christmas and getting a passport for his first vacation, a cruise in March 2018. Like almost all parents, Nichols and her husband have high hopes for their infant son. They plan to take him swimming, and look forward to the boy taking up martial arts when he is old enough. As well as being physically active, their ambition is for Charlie to learn a musical instrument. And in the future, the Nichols want their boy to go to college to become the best possible version of himself. So, although this new mom's journey to motherhood was a difficult one, Nichols would not have had it any other way. It was a tough start to be sure, but with the love of his adoptive family, Charlie now looks set to thrive. Nichols summed up her first few months with her baby boy to humankind. "It just means so much," she said, holding Charlie. "It's more than I could ever imagine or dream of, and just to have the experience to be someone's mom, it's just wonderful. I'm just grateful and humble to have him."